I am the abnormal, the irregularity, the oddball, the weirdo, I am the anomaly.
Sense of Purpose Part 5. In the absolute void of nothingness is where the story continues. The administrator looks into MOD's glowing red eyes. The administrator then says this is personal. The administrator and MOD both get into fighting stands. Me appears saying to everyone this is the final battle, the void of nothingness is where the final battle will take place. Jad then yells to me, this is all your fault. The administrator says to Jad, no, he's a symptom, not the problem. The problem is standing right in front of me. Everyone then notices a mysterious figure standing in the distance behind MOD. The administrator says to the mysterious being, who are you? This being has a body very similar to MOD, except this being's body looks like water illuminated with leaves inside. This being is extremely muscular and much bigger than everyone there, including MOD. The being speaks in an extremely deep voice that echoes throughout the entire plane of nothingness. Right now I am only observing, please carry on, don't let my presence stop you. The administrator and MOD go back to looking into each other's eyes as they both are still in fighting stands. Me says to the administrator, give up, you can't win. You are incompetent and unfit as a leader. Give up and die like the weak coward you are. The administrator is not moved by me's words as he and MOD rush towards each other to begin their final battle. The two clash, giving each other blows so powerful they shake the void of nothingness. MOD quickly gains the upper hand by punching the administrator so hard he skips across the water as he flies miles away. The impact of the punch creates shock waves. MOD catches up to the administrator, grabs him by the ankle and throws him into the sky 4 miles. The administrator recovers in the sky and comes down with a powerful dive kick of his own. MOD blocks this powerful dive kick encounter with a powerful punch that has the administrator flying yet again. When the administrator finally lands on the ground, Rage says to him, let me at him. The administrator gets up slowly and replies, no, please stay back, this is my fight. Me then says, I told you, you can't win. You're too weak, bow before the might of MOD. The administrator replies to me, hey boy, shut the fuck up. He continues, you dick riding motherfucker, the way you're going you might as well bow before the might of MOD's dick and suck it. And as for you MOD, it doesn't matter how many times I fall down, I'm going to keep getting back up. I promise you will fall by my hands. The administrator rushes towards MOD. The administrator cocks back for a powerful punch. MOD blocks the punch, grabs the administrator, and breaks his arm. MOD then shoots the administrator with a beam from his eyes. The administrator is blasted backwards, falling to the ground. The administrator gets back up and says, I guess it's time to start taking this serious. The administrator then says, Symbology Black Obelisk Maximum Output. Just then 12 giant spires appeared behind the administrator in a straight line. Ancient markings appear on each of the spires and then they begin to glow. The sky begins to turn dark gray. Then a white beam of light comes from the sky and strikes MOD, knocking MOD to the ground. The administrator follows up by saying, Jury, 7 orbs of light. Just then 7 orbs of light surrounds MOD, they all collapse into MOD at once. The attack causes a massive explosion, MOD flies from the explosion just fine. MOD then says, Odin Animan Stone Lance. Then thousands of lances appear over the head of MOD. The administrator counters by saying, Jury, Crystal Stone Lance. 10,000 lances made of crystals form over the head of the administrator. Jad, Naomi, Rage, and Valerie are shocked at the amount of power that the administrator has. The two attacks clash, cancelling each other out. Meanwhile Jad, Naomi, Rage, and Valerie feel a presence from behind them. They all turn around. What they see is a male human angel hybrid. Bald with a white button shirt that is open. He has tattoos and a single wing on his back. Jad says to the stranger, who are you? The stranger responds, my name is Kevin, I am a friend. I came to offer assistance to the man you called the administrator anomaly. Unfortunately it looks as though I am too late. MOD has devoured this universe already. Kevin continues, the truth is the administrator is ill prepared to face MOD right now. The way he is now, he cannot win. With that being said, I brought a weapon from my dimension which is best suited for fighting MOD. Kevin hands Naomi a pill. Kevin says to Naomi, I think it's best you give it to him. Meanwhile, the administrator is flying from getting hit so hard by MOD. MOD says to the administrator, this isn't our first time fighting. We have fought many times before. He goes on to say, you may not remember, but you lost every time, each time getting more and more powerful but never winning. MOD with his immense speed catches the administrator and throws him into the sky. Kevin says to Naomi, now is your chance. Naomi then flies into the sky, she catches the administrator. MOD pulls two massive stars, both larger than the sun, from his being. Naomi says to the administrator, I got you, I believe in you. Here, take this. Naomi hands the pill to the administrator. The administrator sees that the pill has hyper-focused 001 written on it. Naomi says to the administrator, the guy who handed me this pill says he's a friend. Then the badly damaged, tattered, and bruised administrator Anomaly looks down to see his best friend Kevin smiling up at him. The administrator clinches the pill tightly within his hand. The administrator then says softly, thank you. The two stars are heading directly for the administrator and Naomi. The administrator quickly swallows the pill. The two massive stars smash into the Anomaly and Naomi. The impact creates a massive supernova. Everyone has to shield themselves from the blast. In the aftermath of the explosion, everyone comes to. There is a tear in reality caused by the explosion. The administrator Anomaly emerge from the tear in reality holding Naomi in his arms. Everyone gasps from the events that has transpired. The administrator now has a colorful aura around his body and white glowing eyes. The administrator puts Naomi down. Naomi says to the administrator, wow, look at you. Naomi runs to safety as MOD charges towards the administrator. MOD swings with a right hook, the administrator vanishes and appears behind MOD, knocking MOD hundreds of miles from his original location. Everyone standing by, jaws drop. Me yells, impossible. The mysterious being observing the battle says, impressive. MOD picks himself up off the ground. MOD then says to the administrator, you are not worthy of such power. MOD charges in for another attack. The administrator kicks MOD in the face so hard MOD flew hundreds of billions of light years into the sky. Everyone is floored at what they are seeing. The administrator says, jury, crystal sword. Then a sword made of crystal appears in the administrator's hand. In that instant, MOD charges downward towards the administrator at hundreds of billions of light years per hour with an attack of his own. MOD's attack seems to have missed the administrator, but MOD quickly finds that his arm has been cut off. MOD says to the administrator, your power should not equal mine. The administrator says to MOD, now I remember, you're right, this is not the first time we fought. In fact, I am not the first administrator you fought. You and I have fought in other universes. You have taken over many universes and took the lives of many administrators in the process. Majesty ordained damnation, Master of Doom, I am here to tell you right here and now that this is as far as you go. I will not go down like the other administrators, and I will not be beaten by you like I was in the past. MOD says to the administrator, my will persist. The administrator replies, that's good. MOD and the administrator charge towards one another for a final attack. MOD cocks back for a punch but never makes it, because the administrator had already knocked his head off and gals his heart out. MOD's final words are, my will persist. The administrator replies, yeah yeah. MOD body starts to glow as his body breaks apart into particles of light. The particles are then absorbed into the administrator's body, making him even more powerful. Jad, Naomi, Rage, and Valerie are all amazed. Kevin smiles at the administrator and says to him, I knew you could do it. In the instant, a mysterious woman descends from the sky. She is short with black hair, wearing thigh-high robotic boots with rocket boosters on them. The mysterious woman and the administrator look at each other. The administrator then says, your presence here confirms something for me. It confirms why you are here as well, the administrator says to the mysterious being who was observing the fight between the administrator and MOD. The mysterious being says to the administrator, you are precisely right. Jad says, what the hell is going on here? Then Naomi says, yeah, I'm sure the viewers are just as confused as we are right now. Naomi quickly covers her mouth and says, oops. Rage and Valerie both yell Naomi. Naomi replies with, sorry, sorry. The administrator says to everyone, in other words, I have to fight him now. Referring to the mysterious being. Then the administrator says to the mysterious being, I didn't catch your name. The mysterious being replies, I don't have a name, but given my purpose you can call me Life. Life says to the administrator, your power is great, but even with all of this power you don't have what it takes to beat me. Rage then asks the administrator, why do you have to fight him? The real battle is done. The administrator replies, yes but no. Life observes the fights between all administrators and MOD for the fate of their universes. Defeating MOD in battle is one thing, but absolutely destroying him is prohibited. Naomi asks the administrator, have other administrators beat MOD as well? The administrator replies, yes, only a handful throughout history. Life then says to the administrator, and yet you broke the rule despite knowing better. The administrator replies, yep. Naomi says to Rage, wow, administrators have rules to follow too. The administrator then says to Life, I hated MOD, the fact that you allow his existence makes you know better. Life says to the administrator, in your universe on the planet called Earth there is a saying, life is not fair. The administrator burst out in laughter. Then the administrator says to Life, I hope Life has insurance because yours is about to end. The administrator yells, I summon Yoko Shimizu. Rage and Valerie both yell Shimizu. A young woman with long black hair wearing technologies that is similar to that of Rage and Valerie descends from the sky. Yoko says to the administrator, how may I help you? The administrator says to Yoko, as you already know, my universe is destroyed. I need you to work with Rage and Valerie to recreate the universe. Life then says to the administrator, that's enough, you have broken enough rules. Life then goes on to say, on guard. The administrator and the mysterious woman turn to face Life, they both get into fighting stance. Life gets into a fighting stance. The administrator asks the mysterious woman, are you ready? The mysterious woman replies, you go first. The administrator replies, fine. Jad asks the mysterious woman, who are you? The mysterious woman replies, you can call me Pain, I am here to offer help to the administrator. Pain goes on to say, you all better stand back, things are about to get ugly. Meanwhile the administrator and Life charge at each other for this final battle. To be continued.